Ellerbrock making his 28th career start. That's tied with David Little for the most in Midwestern State, at least currently on the squad, as the ball kicked away by Jerry Owens. And this time, Thyler catches it, and he dropped it, and he is going to have to fall down on top of it. And the ball's going to be spotted at the 8-yard line. So tonight could be the night at the Follies here at Memorial Stadium.
There's going to be a lot of fumbles, a lot of drops. It's just tough for any player to get out there and handle this ball with any kind of, you know, certainty. It's this weather really makes it tough, Dan.
And it's not like the weather, the conditions favor one team or another, although it hampers the Texans offensively, what they're trying to do. You can also see the effects it's going to have on Midwestern State as well.
Yeah, the Mustangs are a very electric team looking to score on special teams often. And right there you saw where it definitely hampers their opportunities there.
9-11 remains in this first quarter. No score between the Texans and Mustangs as Lester Bush carries the football, and he's going to lose big-time yardage. And he's going to be into the end zone, but that's not a safety as the ball is going to be spotted close to the 4-yard line or around the 3. We'll see where they officially mark it, but the momentum carried him into the end zone.
Yeah, and that's a cardinal rule of football. Lester Bush tries to break around the edge, but when he does, he goes backwards. And I guarantee that Coach Maskell is going to have some words with him and says, listen, in this kind of field position, you can't be running backwards, son. You got to head north and south. You got to go north.
Lester Bush had a big week last week in San Antonio against Incarnate Word. 15 carries, 103 yards, and a touchdown. His longest run of the night was a 19-yarder. Second down and 17 now as the handoff right up the middle as Midwestern State tries to get some room right up the gut. Lester Bush carrying the football. Nice job up front by Brian Ford, a redshirt junior out of Houston, Texas, defensively for the Texans.
Yeah, and Brian Ford coming in with two tackles last week, redshirted all year last year. He's really chomping at the bit to come in here and prove his worth for the Texans.
Clock under 8 minutes here in this first quarter, a rainy Memorial Stadium on a Saturday night. Game delayed about an hour with lightning in the area, but so far so good here, and we are underway with football as Kelsey decides to keep it himself on the option play and really nowhere to go. Good penetration by the Texans up front. That time it was Chase Bowers, a junior out of Panama City, Florida, on the stop.
Yeah, Chase Bowers is in there. Matt Nicky also came up from his outside linebacker position to lay a hit.
So what can we tell offensively through the first two possessions of the game for each team?
Really nothing. I mean, I hate to say that, but really nothing, because both teams can't put together anything worthwhile.
Ellenberg in his own end zone, and now he's in trouble. He's going to try to get this one away. And
he does get it kicked off, but this is only going to go for
This is disaster for Midwestern State. The ball went out of bounds at the 4-yard line. He did avoid the safety, but now the defense is backed up. And there again, I'm not sure if that was the weather. It just looked like good penetration by the Texans defensively.
Absolutely. And right there you see Coach Kerry Fowler dial up the pressure. And what a better, there's no better time to do it than right there where you have the Mustangs backed up, the punter in his own end zone. You put the heat on him, and that time it paid off.
So now the Midwestern State defense, which has been really good all season long. In fact, on the ground, they've only given up 73 yards a game. That's fifth in the country in Division II, as the handoff on first and goal from the 4-yard line is going to pick up about a yard or so. We'll see where they officially spot the football, but the Mustangs going to have to take a stand here as Vaughn carries the football for Tarleton.
Courtney Vaughn gets the ball on that one. Averaged 25 yards per game. Again, we talked about how this running game isn't the top priority for the Texans.
On second down and goal, and Vaughn is tripped up, but it's Stevens getting into the end zone for the touchdown off the left side. And what a fake, as the Midwestern State defense keyed on Vaughn. Instead, Stevens, the quarterback, kept it himself, and Tarleton at the 6:32 mark of this first quarter takes the lead.
And you see Nick Stevens here really faking that, selling it very well as he circles out to his left, jumps, gets into the end zone, making amends for his negative 34 rushing yards on the season.
Jerry Owens on to attempt the extra point as he tries to get the water out of the way there. right at the 10-yard line to spot the ball, and that's right where a big puddle of water is. So Owens, perfect on the year, 12 of 12 as he puts this one up, and it is no good.
Wow.
So not perfect anymore.